Hello everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are going to see how we can create a pandas data frame using different methods. First of all, you need to understand what is a data frame. A data frame is a 2D labeled data structure with columns, and these columns can contain data of different types. This data can be string, it can be numeric, it can be float, double or date time. So what are the different ways to create a pandas data frame? We can create a data frame using a list, then using list of list. It can be created using a dictionary, then using list of dictionaries, then using a zip function, then using dictionary of series. Now one by one, let's see how we can create a data frame using these methods. So first of all, we need to import pandas. So I'm going to import pandas as pd. Then let's run it. Now my pandas is imported. Now let's create a list. So I'm going to create a list and I'm going to call this list as lst. And I'm going to create a list of first 5 natural numbers. So this is my list. Now let's try to create a data frame and call that data frame df. So df is just a variable. So df is equal to pd.dataframe. So this pd.dataframe is an inbuilt function which is present in pandas library. And in this data frame we have to give a parameter. As we can see over here, we have to give a data. So in this data we have to provide the list that we have created. So just give the list. Now let's try to run this code and let's see what is there in df. So write df and run this code. So we can see that a simple data frame is created which is having data in only one column. And by default this column is called 0 because we have not named our column. And our first 5 natural numbers which were present in the list are now represented in the form of a data frame. Now let's try to create or let's try to modify this. Now let's try to move on to the second method that is using list of list, because this will provide us more unique ways to create a data frame. Let's give a list named as LST only and let's try to create a list of list. So first list will be a list of first 5 natural numbers and my second list will be of the bigger natural numbers like 10, 20, then 30, then 40, then 50. Now if I create a data frame, so let me copy this same thing and paste it over here, and if I run this now, I can see that 2 rows are created and 5 columns are created. So basically this list has taken a form of a row, as you can see, and this is the second list and this is the second row. So I hope you are getting clear with it. Now let's try to go more deeper into it. So let's again create a list of list. So in this I'm going to create a list of the names of people and their respective marks got by them in computer subject. So let me give the name of the first student as Ajay. And let's assume that this person got 70 marks in computer science. And let's create another list of another person. Let's name it Rahul. And let's assume this man got 89 marks. Let's take one more person and let's name him Raj. And let's say he got 99 marks. Now if I try to create a data frame using this list of list, and let me copy the same thing, and now if I run it, I can see that Ajay, Rahul and Raj are the names of the students and they have taken a respective column, and the marks 70, 89 and 99 I have taken another column. But now I want to rename my columns. So what I will do, over here I will give a parameter called columns and I'm going to name it using a list called name. And the second will be marks. So they are respectively the column names. So first column name is name and second column name is the marks. So now if I will run it, I can see that my columns are renamed as name and marks. Perfect. Now let's try to create a data frame using dictionary. So let me put third topic as using dictionary. And over here, we have to name it using list of list. Now how we can create a data frame using a dictionary? Let's first of all create a dictionary and let's name it as data. So data is just a variable which is going to store my dictionary. As we know that a dictionary contains keys and the respective values. So let's name the first key as name and provide a list of names. So let me use the same names, Raj, then Rahul, then Ajay. And we have to provide another key as marks. And over here we can create the list of the respective marks scored by the students. So let me write the marks as 89, then 67, then 43, right? Now this is the dictionary. Now let's try to create a data frame using this dictionary and let's see what happens after it. So df is equal to pd dot data frame, and let's give this dictionary. And now let's print this data frame and let's see. So we can see that the same result we can get using this dictionary also. Name and marks are the columns, which were the dictionary keys. And this list, Raj, Rahul, Ajay, they have taken the respective cells, and 89, 67, 43 are the respective marks, and they have taken the spaces in the marks column. Now I want to rename these rows 0, 1, 2. They are called the indexes. So how we can rename an index? So over here only we have to give, let's copy the same thing and paste it over here, and let's name it the index. It is called an index parameter. In the index parameter, I'm going to give a list. Let's name it student1. You can give any index name as per your choice. Let's name it student2 and let's name it student3. And we can see that our index values are also changed. Let's move on to the fourth method of creating a data frame. And the fourth method is how we can create a data frame using list of dictionaries. So let's put the topic using list of dictionaries. So over here, let's try to create our list. Let's name it as LST. So in this list, I'm going to create two dictionaries. So first dictionary, and I have to create the keys. So let's name these keys as A. So basically these keys are going to act as the column names. So A, let's give the value as 1, then another key as small b, let's give the value as 2, then another value c, and let's name it 3. Now in the next dictionary we have to use the same keys because column names are not going to change. So let's give it A, then value 45. Then let's use B and its value will be 89. Then let's use C and its value will be 90. And we can create as many dictionaries as we want. Let's wrap this using this. Yes, now it's correct. Let's create a data frame df pd dot data frame lst and let's print it. So we can see that A, B and C are acting as the column names, and 1, 2, 3, 45, 89 and 90 are the data values. We can create as many dictionaries as we want, but make sure you are using the same column names. I'm going to use A as 56, then B as 90. And let's not print anything for C. Let's forget it. And let's try to wrap this in a dictionary. Now we can see that we have provided A and B over here, but we have not provided C. And this is a list of dictionaries. Now let's see what happens if we don't write a column value. So we can see that if we don't write a column value, we get a null value. So I hope you are getting it till now. So now let's move on to the fifth method, that is creating a data frame using zip function. So let's put the topic using zip function. In this we have to create two lists, and then we will zip both the list using zip function, and we will create a single list. So let's create LST1, or let's name it names. Let me use the same names, Raj, Rahul and Ajay, and let's create the second list as marks. Let's assume they got 56, 78 and 23 marks. Now we are going to create a single list. Let me call it list of students. And let's create a single list using list function. Then we have to zip these two lists. So zip, then names, comma, the second list is marks. And now if I first print this list of students, let's see what we get. So we get a single list of three tuples. Raj is mapped to 56, Rahul is mapped to 78, and Ajay is mapped to 23. Perfect. Now let me create a data frame using this list of students. So df is equal to pd dot data frame, and let's give that same list of students, and we can also give the column names. So columns is equal to, and in a list, let's use names or name and marks. Right? Let's print this df. So we can see that a beautiful data frame is ready with name and marks as the column names. Raj is mapped to 56, Rahul is mapped to 78, and Ajay is mapped to 23. Perfect. Now we have covered five methods of creating a data frame. Let's move on to the sixth method, that is creating a data frame using dictionary of series. So let's put the topic using dictionary of pandas series. So let's name this dictionary as data. And in this, first of all, we have to provide the keys. So let's use a name as Raj, and let's give it a series of all the marks got by the student in all four subjects. Let's take physics, chemistry, maths, and computer. So we have to provide a series. So pd dot series, and we have to give the marks of this student. So let's use 56, 78, 90, and 89. So these are basically the four subject marks of the student. So let's append the data of another student. So let's name it as Ajay. And we have to provide his marks. So pd dot series. And let's take 56, then 34, then 23, then 99. And now let's try to create a data frame using this dictionary. So df is equal to pd dot data frame this data. And let's print this data frame. So we can see that these are the Raj marks and these are the Ajay marks of the four subjects. So I hope you are clear with all the six methods of creating a data frame. If you have any doubts or you want to give us suggestions or feedbacks, you can comment us below. Thank you for watching.